difference in the game were the fours and fives of Oklahoma State. Cisse and Smith in particular were outstanding in those positions.
Another missed three, Oklahoma State 0-for-2 on their first possession from beyond the arc. And we welcome those of you who just saw Wisconsin hang on against Liberty 75-71. The former Oklahoma State Cowboy guard Brendan Manzer, I'm James Westling. We're in Stillwater, Oklahoma, a trip to the NIT quarterfinals on the line. Both teams have started over here in the first minute plus. Nice pass. Cisse can't get it down. And a whistle and a walk, and it'll stay with the Cowboys. An intriguing matchup here today, Brendan, between these two teams. Tell us about the parallels and the main differences between these two groups as you look at Eastern Washington's starting five. Steel Venters had a huge game with 27 for their first round win.
Yeah, James, it's literally elite defense, the athleticism, length of Oklahoma State. And then Eastern Washington, very efficient on the offensive end, solid, they share it, the ball moves. Centered around that guy right there, Steel Venters, who is a terrific scorer, but his teammates play off of him. That's why they are so good together.
Oklahoma State has missed their first three shots. Here's their starting five. Tyreek Smith gets his fifth start in a row, had his first career double-double in their first round win over Youngstown State. Thompson pulls up, can't hit.
You can already see here the first couple of possessions, how Eastern Washington is playing defensively. They're going to meet Oklahoma State at the three-point line, and their priority is containment. They're not going to allow them free looks, but they're going to contest everything.
There is Steel Venters. His first bucket drops in, and Eastern Washington opens up the scoring.
Yeah, just like we were talking about, a complete offensive player. That time away from the ball has great mid-range, really elevates on that jumper with that soft touch.
Tremendous size as well, 6'7". Asbury, in and out. It'll stay with, beg your pardon, it'll go to Eastern Washington. Here's their head coach, David Riley, in the second season, 41-26, the Big Sky Coach of the Year. He's been a part of this program for a long time as an assistant since 2011.
Well, he's an Eagle through and through. Young guy, 34 years of age, but sharp as a tack. You can really tell how his team follows his leadership. Cool guy, but an excellent basketball mind. He's got a great future ahead of him.
Angelo Allegri with the three in Eastern Washington. They look sharp offensively on back-to-back trips. Smith spinning, and one.
When we talk about Smith really elevating his game, always been a defender and rebounder, but he's been giving Oklahoma State a little punch offensively with his back to the basket. Great job of feeling the defense and playing off that left shoulder right there. But he has been more than efficient. His real strength, though, and you're going to get to see it today, is his nose for the offensive rebound.
He had his first career double-double, 13 points and 11 rebounds in the opening round. Right, spinning, can't get it down. Venters with the rebound for Eastern Washington. Oklahoma State has started 1-for-7.
Yeah, a couple of shots at the rim that they have not been able to finish. See Eastern Washington, look at him sprint back to the lane. They really want to protect the paint in transition and in the half court.
Thompson's trailing three is good. 55th three of the year for the sharpshooter from nearby Tulsa.
Yeah, Bryce Thompson, 37% three-point shooter, really at his best when he lets the ball find him. That was a situation right there, even in transition, where he could catch and shoot.
Seven to shoot. Bailed out by a whistle, a foul on the floor. Oklahoma State coached by Mike Boynton in his sixth season, 106-88. Three postseason appearances here at Oklahoma State.
Yeah, Coach Boynton has done a great job rallying from the disappointment of not making the NCAA tournament. Literally the last team not taken close to getting there. But they rallied that second half, especially in Youngstown. I mean, they played like a team with something to prove. They had a couple really good days of practice leading into this afternoon's game as well.
All muscle from Tyreek Smith. He'll be at the line when we come back. Oklahoma State has scored 7 in a row. ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2023 National Invitational Tournament is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors, tested for extremes, designed for your home.
And the edge.
Upgrade to the Disney bundle for even more.
At Papa John's, we start with better. Like marinated oven roasted chicken tossed in our new hot lemon pepper sauce kind of better. And now you can find them on the Papa Pairings menu. Get two or more Papa Pairings favorites for just $6.99 each, only from Papa John's.
For 46 years straight, more of you have trusted Ford F-Series trucks to help save the day. Stretch the weekend. Haul. Or tow. Just about anything, anywhere. That's because they're built Ford tough. And it's why Ford F-Series are America's best-selling trucks 46 years straight. And for that, we thank you. Because this isn't just ability. It's about you.
Saturday. Two of hockey's best in a primetime showdown.
We've battled against each other for a long time, and it's a lot of fun.
The Grade 8 squares off against Sid the Kid. A legendary rivalry.
It's a great battle between me and Sid, and, you know, it's great for hockey.
Get ready for the rush. Capitals Penguins. Saturday on ABC and ESPN+.
The XFL gets you closer to football than ever before. Where anything could happen.
Converted on 4th and 15.
Week 5 of the XFL continues tonight on ESPN2.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2023 National Invitational Tournament is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors. Tested for extremes, designed for your home. Welcome inside historic Gallagher-Iba Arena alongside former Oklahoma State Cowboys guard Brendan Manzer. I'm James Westling. First 4 minutes of this one, it's a close game. What stood out to you?
I think both teams came out playing like we expected them to. You know, we have Venters and Allegri involved, obviously, offensively for Eastern Washington early. Those guys are going to run their offense through those two. And then Oklahoma State playing the way they have to. They have to start inside out, James. You get the three from Bryce Thompson in transition, and then the last two opportunities with Tyreek Smith back to the basket. So they have to start there and eventually force Eastern Washington to maybe have to double team, and then does that free up shooters on the backside?
Oklahoma State with some three-quarters court pressure. What are they trying to do here?
Well, part of it is they want to get out and extend and disrupt Eastern Washington, not make them feel comfortable, but also it takes some time off them getting into their motion offense.
Eastern Washington, a hoist was an air ball. Thompson, no whistle. Allegri wants to fuel the break. Jones blocked, but a foul. It's on Musa Cisse, his first, and it puts Casey Jones at the line for two.
Well, Eastern Washington, they will run in transition. They'll really push. They do a great job of getting the ball to the middle. And then you see Casey Jones right there. He's a really good athlete. Great lane he ran right there and took it right at Cisse. Jones is also appreciate what your teammates bring to the table and whatever strengths that may be. And you can tell they know their roles by the way they share good packs like this.
Smith! Thank you very much. Tyreek Smith already has 7 for the Cowboys.
Yeah, and a big key, we've already alluded to it, is for Oklahoma State to be able to play 2 bigs against Eastern Washington. And that's a way they can do it right there, continuing to attack the paint. Great post-to-post pass from Cisse to Smith.
Hook pass. 3 ball. In and out, no, from Price. Oklahoma State basketball.
Again, Oklahoma State, you get the touch inside, and watch Smith laying flat along the baseline. Venters up the floor, loses sight. Boom, right there. Smith has converted every touch so far he's gotten in the interior.
Already above his season average. He started 5 in a row for Oklahoma State. He led the Cowboys in scoring for the first time in his career against Youngstown State in the opening round win at 13. Short corner with 10 to shoot. Smith goes back to work. Nearly got it down. Rebound Eastern Washington.
Eastern Washington, you saw right there, they can play zone and they'll continue to switch it up, try to keep Oklahoma State a little bit off balance.
Eastern Washington has missed their last 5 field goals. Davis, 3 ball, Price, short. Smith claims his 3rd rebound already.
Well, Price can hit those. He's missed a couple of wide open. He's a 38% 3-point shooter.
Runner wouldn't go for Asbury, wanted a whistle. NASCAR tempo here in Stillwater. Allegri's 3, Gophers out. What do you think about the pace?
Well, we talked to Coach Riley last night, and I asked him, with Oklahoma State's athleticism, are you going to continue to push like you have in the past? And he gave a great answer. He says, if we don't push and do what we've done all season long, I will lose credibility with my guys. And we laugh, but at the same time, he's absolutely correct. They are really good at it. I mean, they have great spacing, and they score a bunch off that transition. So they're going to push when the opportunity is there.
Foul over the back after the miss. This will be number 2 on Musa Cisse. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship 2nd round continues today on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on tournament game times and networks, go to NCAA.com. Eastern Washington hasn't scored in 2.5 minutes. They've missed 7 straight shots. It's a 10-1 Oklahoma State run. Dane Erickstrup has checked in. He's got the ball out high for Eastern Washington. Stroud has also entered. Nice find. And the bucket at the rim for Erickstrup.
Boy, great play right there. Erickstrup did a good job of finding a window where Stroud could get it to him. Stroud did a great job of just letting that play develop.
The lob over the top. Boone is entered for Oklahoma State, but he fumbles the catch. And we'll stay on this end with Oklahoma State.
On those ball screens and rolls from the bigs of Oklahoma State, when they go to that rim, James, watch Eastern Washington. I mean, they're going to converge and collapse on that. They want Oklahoma State to skip pass, and they'd rather contest that weak side 3.
And 1 for Bryce Thompson.
Boy, good movement. See how quick Asbury gets it out of his hands. Bryce Thompson again. Nice little weak side flash right there. When you play Eastern Washington or Oklahoma State, they're not going to get out and press you. They're not really a team that turns people over. So whether they're in man or zone here this afternoon, you know, sometimes you can get comfortable and a little bit stagnant offensively. The ball still has to move crisply. And so far, Oklahoma State has done a really good job of that, getting that defense to shift no matter what D the Eagles are in.
The Eagles need a basket. Off the heel. Out of bounds. Eagles will possession when we come back. Oklahoma State with a four-point lead. Last time these teams met, it was a special year for the Cowboys. We'll party like it's 2004 coming up.
Sonic.
This is great. It's like we're driving in the future.
Pretty different from how I used to do it.
The good old days?
Good days.
Two dreams are the same. But there is one van equipped to handle them all. For over 120 years, Mercedes-Benz vans have been built, upfitted, and ready to go. Because we believe dreams should never stay that way.
The XFL gets you closer to football than ever before. XFL continues tonight on ESPN2.
Well, this is the second time these teams have met all time. The first was in the first round of the 2004 NCAA tournament. Oklahoma State won 75-56. The Cowboys that season, Brendan, they went all the way to the Final Four with Tony Allen and John Lucas. That was a special bunch.
It was. It took Oklahoma State a while to break free from Eastern Washington. I remember that game, but yet, obviously a great team, coached by legendary Eddie Sutton. Joey Graham also on that team. Ivan McFarland, who was, you asked Oklahoma State fans to name some of their favorite all-time Cowboys, he would be on that list. And not surprising with the coaching of Eddie Sutton, several pros that they had the type of year that they had.
I can't believe
that's 19 years ago.
I know.
That's.
Do you remember who they beat in the Elite Eight to get to the Final Four?
St. Joe's.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Jameer Nelson, Delonte West.
Wow, those two guys were great together.
A kick. Eastern Washington. Brendan, they're now 3-for-13 from the field, 1-for-8 from deep. What's going on offensively?
Well, I would be concerned if they weren't a jump shooting team. They are. And they've gotten pretty good looks. Price has been wide open on a couple for Coach David Riley. He's a 38% three-point shooter. Oklahoma State really has dodged that bullet. And to be honest, with Eastern Washington struggling shooting the ball, you know, Oklahoma State hasn't probably separated like they would have liked to.
Look at these numbers from Oklahoma State's D this season. Second in the Big 12 in scoring defense. Lead the conference, 13th in the nation in field goal percentage defense. Allegri's three, finally got one to drop. Second three of the game for the Eagles.
Yeah, Allegri, when his feet are set, I mean, it's almost money. It was 42% from three in conference play, 53% overall. So he takes great shots as well.
Newton bouncing back door, can't clear his shot. Contact. Offensive foul. Oklahoma State turnover.
Here's that three from Allegri. Five out motion, way too wide open right there. It's separation from the freshman from Oklahoma State, Keon Williams. You know, Allegri, we talked about him taking good shots, but he's had two games where he's made six threes. Game earlier against Portland State and also Weber State.
Venters blocked out of bounds. This Eastern Washington team, I mean, they're eighth in the nation in field goal percentage. 49.3% as a team.
And what's really impressive about that to me is they don't really get a lot of looks with their back to the basket. Now, in the Big Sky, because they do have good size relative to that league, they can post guys like Allegri and Venters because they're bigger. But it's not really their bread and butter, shooting the basketball. That's what makes it so impressive that they are so efficient.
Corner three from Wright. Yes. John Michael Wright. He's been a walking flamethrower for the Cowboys.
In the last four games, he has really struggled from three. So I know Coach Boynton happy to see that.
Thompson Euro step in the finish.
One of the things I was going to mention, with Eastern Washington being able to hang around while not shooting it great, they've mostly taken care of the ball. In that instant, they did not. Oklahoma State able to use their athleticism to turn it into points.
Three ball goes down for Erickstra. It's a 6'10 post player stepping out and knocking down number 20 on the year. Ball's in backcourt. Scrum. Oklahoma State pulls it out of the pack. The lob, too high. Three on one for the Eagles. The lob and the finish. Over the top, Cedric Coward. It's a one-point game.
Well, that's typically what happens. When you don't convert, James, like Oklahoma State didn't do, immediately the other team could go down in a broken floor and convert as Eastern Washington did.
Pocket pass knocked away. Fourth Oklahoma State turnover. Bucket good for Erickstra.
Yeah,
Dane Erickstra has seven off the bench.
Yeah, sorry, James. Had the mismatch inside. Great recognition, immediate recognition from Eastern Washington with the size advantage there.
What a lift off the bench. 7 points in 4 minutes. Caleb Boone steps through a double, throws it up, and it rolls home. What do the Cowboys need from him today?
Just some positive things to happen. He's a guy that can get going. Third team all-conference in the Big 12. So that gives you a little glimpse of what his capabilities are. But he's the type of player that needs something positive to happen to get him going. Maybe that's it. And then something positive, Erickstra right there. We've seen him knock down the shot. A little answer right here from Caleb Boone. Caleb Boone has tremendous feel with his back to the basket. He always feels those defenders. Great sense of double teams and where they're coming from.
You see the uptick in his production. Played about 15 minutes per game a season ago. This season, he had a stretch in January over a six-game period where he scored 17 points per night. Newton can't hit the dot. The Eagles looking to reclaim the lead. Davis on the handle with 10 to shoot. Navigating in some trouble. Timer at five. Stroud a long way from the cup. Stroud doesn't recognize his shot clock violation. Suffocating defense from Oklahoma State. A one-point lead for the Cowboys here in Stillwater.
Treats under $2.
Under $2.
And under $3. Some of Sonic's most craveable favorites.
Some of Sonic's most craveable favorites.
You never know when you might need something delicious, because cravings come in different sizes, just like pants. Except you don't eat pants. Sonic under $2 and $3 craves.
Sonic.
Is it March already?
No two dreams are the same. But there is one van equipped to handle them all. For over 120 years, Mercedes-Benz vans have been built, upfitted, and ready to go. Because we believe dreams should never stay that way.
Michaela Shiffrin, the winningest skier in history.
It doesn't matter how many wins or whatever, it's just go for it.
Shiffrin has made history.
Welcome back to Stillwater, Oklahoma. Oklahoma State leads Eastern Washington 19-18. A special moment of Southern Hoops. Morgan William hits the game-winning shot over UConn, ending their 111-game win streak.
I'm tired. We're in overtime. I'm tired. Don't want to go into another overtime. So I'll go get the ball.
William on the drive. Pull up.
Red lights on the backboard, the ball in the net.
It's over. Mississippi State has ended the streak. All seven episodes of Southern Hoops, a history of SEC basketball, are now streaming on ESPN Plus and SEC Network Plus. Our game here, 1-point lead for Oklahoma State. Eastern Washington hanging around. They have 7 points off of 4 Oklahoma State turnovers, but all the last 4 minutes.
Which is interesting, because Eastern Washington turns teams over only 11 times per game. They just don't get out and pressure a lot. So 4 turnovers against them the first 13 minutes is a lot. Oklahoma State's got to take better care of it.
And they're deep in the shot clock and a steal.
Yeah, there's the fifth one right there. Very alert defensive play to dig down on top of Cisse the moment he put it on the deck.
Only one Big 12 team turned it over more than Oklahoma State. That was K-State this season. Price shovels. Davis jousting with 6 to shoot. Down to 2 on the ticker. Fall away, blocked by Smith.
Another sound defensive possession from Oklahoma State. Eastern Washington's difficult to defend, James, because they run motion. And there's rules, but they're allowed to play freely. And so you can't just scout them necessarily and cover sets. They run sets at times, but basically they just go play. So your defensive principles have to be intact. You got to communicate. You got to talk through screens, talk on your switches. And Oklahoma State's had back-to-back possessions where they've been sound, kept everything in front.
Smith already has 7, gets his own miss, up to 9 points.
Which just continues to produce. He's got that high motor. And he also is able to finish through contact.
Money from the outside for Angelo Allegri. That's his third trifecta. Knocks the score at 21.
Now, Oklahoma State is not getting to him on the catch. All these perimeter players for Eastern Washington, even Price, you have to be there on the catch and not allow space.
Cisse, a double-fisted dunk. The assist, John Michael Wright threading the needle. All right, on this end, is there anybody in the Big 12 that could compare to Eastern Washington in terms of that motion offense?
Not really. Oklahoma a little bit, ironically, with Tanner Groves at that five spot. Does some similar things as what Price does.
So it's a tough scout for Oklahoma State.
Yeah, and it's, you know, teams in the Big 12 have multiple guards like that right there that get downhill after ball movement. Eastern Washington is more move you with passing.
It's Caleb Asbury in attack mode. Coming up later, the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship second round continues on ESPN and ESPN2 with Arizona Maryland at 5:30 Eastern, then Princeton Utah at 7, Michigan LSU at 7:30, and Ole Miss Stanford at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. All games are also available on the ESPN app. Angel Reese had 34 points in their opening round win. Also at 15 rebounds, 3 steals, did it on both ends for LSU.
That's about a 3-week span for me in my my illustrious career. Time performance right there. I was going to say, speaking of Tanner Gross, you sit behind that Eastern Washington bench. David Riley recruited he and Jacob Gross, who transferred. And Tanner Gross out of eligibility, but Jacob, I would assume, would be back at Oklahoma for another year.
Allegri's runners off the heel, out of bounds to Oklahoma State. And that Eastern Washington team, they gave Kansas a scare in the NCAA tournament.
And you know, the question was, well, can Tanner Gross play in the Big 12? And Bill Self said, absolutely, because he had 35 on Kansas in that game.
Lob and a dunk. Boone rises up to slam it home.
Well, I like what Oklahoma State continues to do is attack the interior. That's where the opportunities and advantages are. That 4 and 5 position with the size and athleticism of Oklahoma State.
Davis losing the handle. Shovel. Jones lines it up, and he cans it. To your point, points in the paint, though, 18-6 in favor of Oklahoma State.
And really, Eastern Washington, other than the turnovers, and that was a broken four off a 50-50 ball, when Oklahoma State has got them in the half court, taking care of the ball, they've been just fine.
Williams pulls the trigger. Pops out. Eastern Washington fighting here on the road, not going away. Allegri dancing, throws it up and in off the window.
Just tough. It's almost like James, he quietly goes about his production. You think, oh, he's having a nice game, and you look up, he has 11 points already.
That was a sick move. Open three for Williams. Hard fall down low. Out of bounds to the Cowboys.
Well, James, Oklahoma State continues to attack the interior in the paint. It's been Smith, Cisse. This time it's Caleb Boone, but Eastern Washington hanging tough here in Stillwater.
The NCAA is instrumental in Team USA's success at the Olympics. At the Summer Games, over 75% of Team USA's athletes competed collegiately, representing over 150 U.S. colleges and universities across divisions 1, 2, and 3. And now they compete to bring home medals for our nation. The college athlete experience, a building block for success. The NCAA is proud Olympians and Paralympians are made here.
At Papa John's, we start with better, like marinated oven roasted chicken tossed in our new hot lemon pepper sauce kind of better. And now you can find them on the Papa Pairings menu. Get two or more Papa Pairings favorites for just $6.99 each, only from Papa John's.
For 46 years straight, more of you have trusted Ford F-Series trucks to help save the day. Stretch the weekend. Haul or tow. Just about anything, anywhere. That's because they're built Ford tough. And it's why Ford F-Series are America's best-selling trucks 46 years straight. And for that, we thank you. Because this isn't just about our capability. It's about yours.
Tree's hungry.
We just stopped. What are you doing?
Photosynthesis.
No two dreams are the same. But there is one van equipped to handle them all. For over 120 years, Mercedes-Benz vans have been built, upfitted, and ready to go. Because we believe dreams should never stay that way.
The XFL gets you closer to football than ever before. Where anything could happen.
Converted on 4th and 15.
Week 5 of the XFL continues tonight on ESPN2.
All right, thanks, Kevin. Looking ahead, the NIT on ESPN today, Morehead State, UAB, Sam Houston, North Texas, UCF in Oregon, and Utah Valley in Colorado. Of these four games, which one are you most excited about?
Well, the winner of this one, playing Sam Houston or North Texas. I have had both those teams this year. Jason Hooten's team at Sam Houston, terrific defensively. Grant McCaslin's North Texas team, outstanding defensively. That will be a grinder. And whoever the winner is and faces one of these teams next will have their hands full.
First one to 40 in that one, huh?
Very well could be. And Alfonso was exactly right. He talked about how well Eastern Washington is taking care of the ball. Just four turnovers. You know, when you go on the road, assuming defense and rebounding is there, as Oklahoma State turns it over again, you have to take care of the ball, and they've done a terrific job of that.
In and out from Davis. It'll stay on this end with the Eagles, but Eastern Washington, they're heating up offensively. They've made 6 of their last 10.
Well, you mentioned it. I agree with you. And Oklahoma State has been, for the most part, sound defensively. But also, if you're being honest, Eastern Washington missed some looks early. Typically, they're going to make more of those. And that's what started to happen.
That was a tough shot from Vinters. Skip past Williams, a hop step. Thompson relocates. Fires, and he drills it.
Great job by Williams. You get the ball moving, you get a skip pass, so you make that low man guard you in that zone. Williams drives to the heart, and that was a great relocation from Bryce Thompson.
Thompson looks comfortable today. Rebuttal off the mark.
Allegri slicing in, and he puts it through.
Yeah, that's tough right there because he had Boone right behind him. But notice how strong that was and sure with the finish.
It's up to a Baker's dozen, 13, 6-7, and can handle it. Thompson heat check is in. 13 for Bryce Thompson.
That's the one thing about Thompson. So many times this year when he gets one to go down, he gets one on the last possession, he starts catching fire. Look for Oklahoma State to continue to get the ball to him as they close out the half.
Fifth Eastern Washington blunder. Oklahoma State looking to add to their lead.
Now here's the first one. Drive to the heart of the defense. That's as good as a post touch, right? You get to the paint. You kick out. Now he's in rhythm. The basket's bigger. Boom. It's, as you said, a heat check. Back-to-back threes from Bryce Thompson.
You were a sharpshooter. It's so much better on an inside-out pass from downtown,
no
right?
No doubt. I mean, because you're naturally squared up to the basket.
Thompson, that's his first miss from downtown today. Fight for the rebound. A scrum and a jump ball.
It also allows you to step into it. You know, get your rhythm, particularly when your shot, the rhythm comes from your footwork. You can see on that drive and kick, for example, from William to Bryce Thompson. It was a good 1-2 pull-up shot. And we haven't seen it much from Venters. Oklahoma State's done a nice job on him, but he is as pure a jump shooter as you'll find. And part of that is he's got, as you see him right there at 6'7". He's got great footwork.
Oklahoma State picks up in some pressure. A little over a minute left before we break for intermission. Eric Strupp lines it up. Oklahoma State corrals it. They've made 9 of their last 14 field goals. Asbury drills it. His first field goal of the day. Oklahoma State's on a 6-0 run. Largest lead of the half for the Cowboys. Shoot. Venters. Offensive rebound. Block and a foul, and this will put Casey Jones at the stripe.
Well, that's Jones right there. And if you're an Oklahoma State person, he is their Tyreek Smith. So active on the offensive glass. 7 offensive rebounds in the last 3 games.
That's the third foul on Musa Cisse for Oklahoma State. 5.3 seconds left in this first half. Jones now 2 for 3. Coming up later, the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship second round continues on ESPN and ESPN2 with Arizona, Maryland at 5:30 Eastern, Princeton, Utah at 7, Michigan, LSU at 7:30. Ole Miss, Stanford at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. All games are also available on the ESPN app. They changed the foul.
Yeah, they're going to give the Tyreek Smith, so that means Musa Cisse just has such a. That's obviously big for Oklahoma State and Mike Boynton.
That's only the first on Tyreek Smith. 6-point lead for Oklahoma State here in Stillwater.
Being mornings. Planning, precision, sweat, sacrifice, and teamwork. That's why Old Dominion.
Alongside Brendan Manzer, I'm James Westling. Oklahoma State has it with 5.3 seconds left, up six. What Mike Boynton draw up during the dead ball?
Yeah, plenty of time right here. It's an eternity, especially with the athleticism of Oklahoma State. You want to set up something right here where you can get downhill. Try to get the defense as flat as you can. Eastern Washington, so this is pickup. You're just going to keep everything in front. Don't let anything get behind you if you're the Eagles. They want to slow up that potential for Thompson or John Michael Wright to push with 5.3 seconds left.
Thompson's had the hot hand with 13 points in this first half. Ahead to John Michael Wright. Williams, a good look. It's good. Wow, what a play to end the half.
What a great offensive play right there. You get the flash from the big to the middle of the floor. Immediately hitting a streaking John Michael Wright down the right side. Now watch Tyreek Smith's flash, shows hands. There's John Michael Wright. Pass right on the money to a 22% three-point shooter, but in rhythm right there. The Fred kept them within striking distance as you go into the second half.
There's the two top scorers in that first session. 13 points for each. You mentioned Venters. He averages 16 a game. He's the Big Sky Player of the Year, has just two. How do they get him involved?
I think Eastern Washington's going to continue to play the way that they play. He actually had some looks early that he normally makes, and they just didn't get to go down. I did think Oklahoma State defended him better. Caleb Asbury, most of that assignment as they have progressed. I mean, I'd be surprised if he doesn't get going here a little bit in the second half.
John Michael Wright gives it up. Thompson, another? No. Oklahoma State outscored Eastern Washington 22-12 to end that first half. Nice seal, but the catch is offline and out of bounds. Here's the NIT bracket. The winner of this one gets North Texas or Sam Houston. They tip it for Eastern over on ESPN+. Wisconsin survived against a hounding Liberty team, 75-71. Cisse faces, barrels in, double pump, and he draws a foul.
There's that touch inside again, and Price just gave up the angle right there. Actually, where Cisse caught it, I think David Riley would be more than comfortable with. You know, 8-10 feet from the basket. Cisse not as skilled, certainly, as Caleb Boone. And the way Tyreek Smith's been playing lately, not as productive with his back to basket as him, but Price just gave up that angle.
Foul was on Price of Eastern Washington. Cisse, just a 42% foul shooter. Right to the second. Eastern Washington, 36% from the field in the first half. 49% for the year, eighth best in the country. Price is rejected at the rim. Top shot blocker in the Big 12, Cisse with number 61. Cisse sets the screen. Wright pulls up. Foul. It's on Price, and that is number three.
And Price right there, it's his third, so David Riley will have to get him out and manage his minutes. And one of the things that he has been better about Price in his second year, not getting his foul trouble as much as a season ago. That's big for Eastern Washington. He's the biggest body and most capable to handle the bigs of Oklahoma State.
Thompson nails from the top his fourth three. Oklahoma State has their largest lead. It's 12.
much space right there. Obviously, Eastern Washington, they're going to keep things in front, which is fine, but you have to highly contest those jumpers better.
A steal and a foul. Venters commits his second.
Now take a look. See Bryce Thompson hit three of these in the first half. Protecting drive right there. But that little jab, get the defender to just take a half step back. Gives Thompson enough space as he squared up to the basket.
He can fill it up in bunches. This is his 10th game of the year with more than three threes. He's got four today. At seven against Kansas, his old team. Back on December 31st. 10 to shoot. Here's Smith. Smith, shovel, and a dunk. Cisse slams it down. Plus one.
Well, in the first half, Oklahoma State had nine assists. Three of them came via Smith and Cisse. Cisse had two, and now that's Smith's second assist himself. So, good interior, big-to-big passing Oklahoma State has had. When one big has caught, the other has not stood and has vacated to an open opportunity.
Cisse gets the free throw down. 15-point cushion. The first 6 points of the second half belong to the Cowboys. Corner three, Venters off the side of the glass. Out of bounds to Oklahoma State.
See that much of that from Venters hitting that side of the backboard. But he's got to continue to take those shots. You know, to me, I know they run a lot of motion, but I'd almost run something specifically for him. Get him a bucket of some kind, maybe get him to the foul line. The scores like that, you've seen it all the time, James. Once that lid come off, they can start filling it up.
Too long from Thompson. Cisse battling. Thompson wants it again. Lob, Cisse. Miss. Wrestling match. Whistle, jump ball. Eastern Washington possession. Oklahoma State's on a 9-0 run, bridging the two halves together, and they've pushed their lead to 15 here at home.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Time for basketball. The pressure is building in the West. And every game matters. Where a win can decide playoffs or play-in. Warriors, Mavs, and Suns, Lakers on ESPN. No two dreams are the same. But there is one van equipped to handle them all. For over 120 years, Mercedes-Benz vans have been built, upfitted, and ready to go. Because we believe dreams should never stay that way.
The XFL gets you closer to football than ever before. Where anything could happen.
Converted on fourth
night on ESPN2.
Coming up later, the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship second round continues on ESPN and ESPN2 with Arizona, Maryland at 5:30 Eastern, Princeton, Utah at 7, and Michigan LSU at 7:30, a 6-3 matchup there. And Ole Miss Stanford at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. All games are also available on the ESPN app. South Carolina, could they get another? Two of the last five on the winning side.
They rolled again today in Greenville over South Florida by 31.
Our game here, a 15-point lead for Oklahoma State. What have the Cowboys done defensively to tighten the screws?
I just think they've been sound. They've kept everything in front. Now, Eastern Washington, not a team that really is going to attack you off the bounce without a lot of ball movement. But you still have to be disciplined.
Allegri up to 16 points. That's his fourth three. First points for Eastern Washington this half.
Yeah, you have to crowd him. He does not take a bad three, but he gets his feet set and has any time at all, he's money. He's been money this afternoon.
Cisse lost it. Right down the middle. Erikstrup with the finish. Nice pass from Jones.
Nice little mini 5-0 run for the Eagles with that three from Allegri. And again, points off turnovers for Eastern Washington.
Five advantage for the Eagles. Points off turnovers. Asbury in trouble. Eighth Oklahoma State turnover. Down low. Jones flies in and the sweeping scoopers in. It's a 7-0 flurry. Thompson looking for number five. Allegri one-on-one against Asbury. Kick out Venters. Cisse rips it down.
Boy, steal Venters can't buy one. That's a shot for him. That'll go down 70% of the time.
It's his best look all day. Smith, yes.
Good job, Oklahoma State, going back to the interior. And that's reading tempo. Bryce Thompson missed the three on the previous possession. Eastern Washington, a little momentum. Smart time, tempo, decision-making from your guards if you're Oklahoma State.
That's a big five-point swing. Nine to shoot for the Eagles. Erikstrup. Asbury flies in for it. Cowboys want to run. Right corner pocket. Buckets.
Well, that's a great look by Asbury. John Michael Wright off the miss from the Eagles. Sprints to that left corner. Just spots up.
Erikstrup's rebuttal is money from the top.
Good off the bench for the Eagles. Now in the double figures.
Coaching a season high. Foul on the floor.
Oklahoma State, 6 3-point makes in the first half. Another two so far here in the second. Here's that last one in transition. John Michael Wright.
At Papa Don's, we start with better, like marinated oven roasted chicken tots in our new hot lemon pepper sauce kind of better. And now you can find them on the Papa Pairings menu. Get two or more Papa Pairings favorites for just $6.99 each, only from Papa John's.
For 46 years straight, more of you have trusted Ford F-Series trucks to help save the day, stretch the weekend, haul, or tow. Just about anything, anywhere. That's because they're built Ford tough. And it's why Ford F-Series are America's best-selling trucks 46 years straight. And for that, we thank you. Because this isn't just about our capability.
different from how I used to do it.
The good old days?
Good days. Bad hair.
For bathroom odors that linger, try Febreze Small Spaces. Just press firmly and it continuously fights odors in the air and on soft surfaces for 45 days.
Second round NIT action. Cincinnati won yesterday over Hofstra, who took down Rutgers in overtime in the first round. Cincinnati takes care of business. This was a wild finish. Tyron Lawrence scored the game-winning layup with 10 seconds left, had 24 points. Vandy takes down Michigan 66-65. Earlier today, a couple of guards went off in this one. Darius McGee had 31 for Liberty. Chucky Hepburn had 27 for Wisconsin. They prevail 75-71.
They needed all 27. Winning that four-point ball game. Hey, watch out for Cincinnati. I really like where Wes Miller's ball club is right now. And also, future Big 12 conference man.
Yeah, how do you think they'll compete next year in the Big 12?
I think, obviously, has great tradition anyway.
Yeah.
I think he's a very good coach. I think they'll get an uptick in players. Not that they don't have good players now. Kelvin Sampson's Houston team, you think they'll fit in to the Big 12?
Just a bit. The way they defend and the dudes they have on that team, offensive foul, it's on Newton.
I think the same will happen with Brigham Young. It's already the home atmosphere at the Marriott Center is terrific. That certainly will fit right in. It'll be fun next year because for 1 year you're going to have 14 teams.
A ton of games.
Hopefully that means you and I will be working.
I hope so. Enters, struggled with it. Here come the Cowboys. Right, that's his spot. Williams, and it wrenched loose by Stroud. A race to the rim. Got it. Eastern Washington trims it back to single digits.
Well, as well as Oklahoma State has done things, I think they've tried to play the right way here today at both ends of the floor. But they're not taking care of the basketball. 10 turnovers now. 13 points off turnovers for the Eagles. And again, this is a team that doesn't turn people over typically. You know, it's allowed them to hang around.
They're a team that can catch fire in a hurry.
That's
just
right.
From Boone.
That's right. And that's all they need to do. I mean, they're hanging around on the boards. They're not getting dominated there.
Allegri's three offline. Tap out. Venters was almost Johnny on the spot. Back to the Cowboys.
Until Allegri is rethinking. That shot right there, there's the hands, the steal transition. Ooh, a nice finish right there. His footsteps behind Stroud. Nice athletic play with that broken floor.
Stroud, he's got a great build. 6'5", 200. Played at UTEP and then Fresno State. And really had a steal.
Yeah, and he's a really good piece because he gives them a guy that drives a little bit, especially after ball movement. Kind of a slasher. Blends well with some of the scoring and shooters that the Eagles have.
Oklahoma State led by 9 at the half. It's 8 now. Wright dashes baseline. Boone turned down an open look. Wright the land of the trees. Boone on the follow with the slam.
Well, he hung up in the air just long enough to let that ball come off the rim.
Stroud gets downhill again. A whistle and a foul called on Caleb Boone of Oklahoma
boon that Oklahoma State fans saw back in January when he had that six-game stretch, averaged 17.8 points per game during that period. Also had 10 blocks.
You know, from your bigs, if you're a coach, regardless of the skill set, great back-to-basket player in Boone, Cisse, elite defender, you have to have a high motor because you need those guys to be active at both ends of the floor, especially here at Oklahoma State. So that's really where their length and athleticism is. They're athletic on the perimeter, but they lost a tremendous amount of athleticism out front when Avery Anderson went down with the injury. So really where they are elite and high level from those three guys inside. And Caleb Boone, regardless of whether he's scoring or not, he's got to understand, he just needs to bring that motor. And you saw it on that follow-up.
Oklahoma State with their 11th turnover. The guard, Avery Anderson, I mean, that's 11 points per game that Oklahoma State hasn't had the last 12 games of the season. I mean, that's crunch time basketball down the stretch you're missing.
And 3.5 assists, and his four game was really good that month into the injury. And I think more than the offensive part of it, they miss his defense. He's had some really good defensive performances. One up in Lawrence early in conference against Grady Dick.
Rare turnover for Eastern Washington.
If you're being honest, you have Avery Anderson. You probably get one more win somewhere, and they're in the NCAA tournament.
Yep. Newton's three, and they're bang. Eastern Washington can get it down to six, maybe five on this possession. Only led for 2 minutes. Stroud's three, halfway down, out. Eric Strip followed. Nobody stays with it. The perseverance pays off. Timeout, Oklahoma State. Eastern Washington has it down to six.
Dane Eric Stripper. Watch this right here. Second effort. His body will get better, but he's showing a little physicality right there. Eastern Washington not going away.
It's Slim Sanity at Slim Chickens, featuring a head-to-head matchup of two new wing flavors. Get some saucy sweet heat, honey hot, a glaze of honey mixed with maple and smoldering cayenne, or that tangy southern taste of Carolina Gold, a zesty, rich southern sauce with a subtle kick. Try them with a meal or feed your hungry crowd. Delicious additions to the House Wing Flavors lineup. Take your Slim Sanity to the next level and play the game for a chance to win. Only at Slim Chickens.
This is great. It's like we're driving in the future.
Pretty different from how I used to do it.
The good old days?
Good days. Bad hair.
Time for basketball. The pressure is building in the West. And every game matters. Where a win can decide playoffs or play-in. Warriors, Mavs, and Suns, Lakers on ESPN.
ABC Hockey Saturday. The Great Eight squares off against Sid the Kid.
It's a great battle between me and Sid, and, you know, it's great for hockey.
Capitals Penguins, Saturday on ABC and ESPN+.
Anderson and how much the Cowboys have missed him the last 12 games. This is a double-digit scorer. His experience alone, 109 career games. And on Selection Sunday, Joe Lenardi had Oklahoma State as the first team out. You brought this up earlier. One more quad one win probably gets them in.
A lot of opportunities, obviously, when you're playing the Big 12. And, you know, you have an Anderson, you probably get one somewhere down the stretch. And also, you have to look, you know, the committee looks at it as a whole body of work. Loss here to Southern Illinois in November. Gave up, I believe, an 18-point lead on neutral side against Central Florida. So it all adds up. And they had Anderson at those times. But really good players. And I'll tell you what, as John Michael Ryan hits another three, he gives them somebody that can literally take you off the bounce at any time. They did lose that. You know, although Asbury and John Michael Ryan, et cetera, can do that.
Oklahoma State with the steal. Thompson knifing and he throws it away. Eastern Washington, their first round win at Washington State. They won by 7. They were down 9 with 10 minutes to go, FYI. Foul on the floor. For the third straight year, every NCAA Women's Championship game is on the networks of ESPN. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. Allegri whistles it outside. 10 to shoot. Allegri into the paint. Double pump. And a foul.
Let's take a look. So Allegri, this is a nice job. A little change of pace, see a little hesitation. So he gets Cisse to leave his feet. Well, that's a tough call right there.
Take another look. Did he get him anywhere with the body, arm? From the line, 75% for the year. First team all Big Sky. He's had a fantastic day with 18 points and 3 assists.
Yeah, really good. I mean, does not blow by you with the basketball, but always finds himself in the heart of the defense. And then once he gets there, his decision making is always high level. Now I'll go back to what you brought up, James. This feels a lot like the game in Pullman. You're exactly right. Think that Washington State was going to pull away, never did. This tough-minded Eastern Washington team just kept hanging around until they got on a little run, trying to do the same here.
Deep in the shot clock, acrobatic scooper from right.
Strong drive right there. Once he got the angle, once the help didn't come over, he was not going to be denied with that left hand.
Back to double digits. Against Williams, misses with the left, and it's Oklahoma State's basketball.
Well, you like the matchup with Williams on Price, but he turned right into where the help was built in with Smith. If he's going to find a way, back his way down, try to get himself over that left shoulder.
Three Eastern Washington starters, Davis, Venters, and Price, have combined for just 2 points. Look out! Cisse! Oklahoma State leads by 12. What a play! Long three, barely nicks the rim, out of bounds, back to the Cowboys.
Nice two-man play right here. Building Oklahoma State's lead to 12, that's Bryce Thompson. And with that length, athleticism, just throw it up somewhere near the rim, he'll do the rest.
Papa Pairings menu. Get two or more Papa Pairings favorites for just $6.99 each, only from Papa John's.
For 46 years straight, more of you have trusted Ford F-Series trucks to help save the day. Stretch the weekend. Haul or tow. Just about anything, anywhere. That's because they're built Ford tough. And it's why Ford F-Series are America's best-selling trucks 46 years straight. And for that, we thank you. Because this isn't just about our capability. It's about yours.
Is it March already?
Mm-hmm. Next stop, Final Four.
It's nothing.
Sounds like something. When you have nausea, heartburn,
indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea. Pepto-Bismol coats and soothes for fast relief when you need it most.
Oklahoma State has carved out a 12-point lead with 7:39 to go here at home. Here's a throwback. Georgia upsets Michael Jordan and the North Carolina Tar Heels in the 1983 NCAA Regional Final.
This would be the biggest upset maybe in the history of the NCAA tournament. James Banks in the drive.
That was a high for us.
A tremendous moment of glory for the basketball program at the University of Georgia.
One guy on there, he didn't know what conference we were from. I just wanted to tell you, who's from the SEC?
All seven episodes of Southern Hoops, a history of SEC basketball, are now streaming on ESPN Plus and SEC Network Plus.
James, you're a lot younger than I am, but when you think of Georgia basketball in the 80s, who do you think of?
Georgia basketball in the 80s? Put me on the spot.
Human highlight reel.
Dawkins? No, Wilkins.
But now, he was not on that team.
Okay.
Vern Fleming was. He was also a legend there.
So Dominique Wilkins went to Georgia and then played for the Hawks. Never had to leave home. Thompson gets it back for Oklahoma State after some sloppy play. Williams! Cisse tried to keep it alive. Eastern Washington basketball. Easton Washington hasn't hit a shot in almost 3 minutes.
Yeah, I tell you what, if you told David Riley that was 7 minutes left, you would have only turned the ball over 10 times, and Oklahoma State has only five off of that, and that Oklahoma State's rebounding advantage is only plus four, I think you'd feel great about that. What you wouldn't expect, how are they now from three? Are they 7 of 25? 7 of 25. And Oklahoma State certainly has overall played good D, but there's been looks that this team normally hits. They just haven't gone down here this afternoon.
That foul's on Musa Cisse, and that is his fourth. The Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year last season, 2022. Juan Harris, the guard from Kansas, won it this year. Davis has not scored. I brought this up a moment ago. Three starters, Price, Davis, and Venters, have combined for just 2 points for Eastern Washington. And remember, Venters had the first bucket of the game for the Eagles, hasn't scored since.
Yeah, I used to assume he was going to have his normal day. But still enough time. You know, we'll see. he stay with those four fouls? Eastern Washington sure like to get him out of the game. There's been a significant drop off defensively when Smith and Cisse have not been in there today.
Cisse gets it back out on the arc. Another Cisse rebound. Eighth offensive rebound today for Oklahoma State. We'll milk some clock. Williams with five to shoot. Thompson has to hoist. Got it!
Good decision right there from Williams. Drives it, nowhere to go. Sometimes he's lowered his head and tried to do too much.
And the answer on the other end. Davis with his first points from the field.
Yeah, and a big answer with the 14-point lead. Eastern Washington, they need to string a series of stops here. When you get three or four in a row, hopefully allow your offense to help you get back within arm's distance.
Nice pass. Smith, he was out of bounds on the catch. Got too deep.
Another good look from Cisse. Yeah, no question. You know, that and the stepping on the sideline by shooters, James. I mean, I know the three-point line has extended since certainly I've played, but the court hadn't gotten any bigger. Always surprises me that lack of court awareness sometimes from these guys.
Down low, Jones able to muscle it through.
Yeah, great recognition. So you had Jones with Keon Williams on his back right there. Good choice from Eastern Washington.
Third player in double figures for the Eagles. Runner, offensive foul. If you're Eastern Washington, at what point in time do you ask Steele Venters to hunt his shot? Or is that just not how they're built?
No question about that charge right there. No, I think, you know, he has to continue to put pressure on Oklahoma State. I think that with him struggling, he's not coming off screens as much. With I'm looking to score, hasn't been as forceful. See right there on that curl. Well, even if he doesn't score, you know, he's drawing all kinds of attention.
He's the Eagles' top scorer at 16 per game this season. He's been held to two. Two in black has 2 points on 1-for-9 shooting. Thompson, this guy can't miss. His sixth three of the game. And he has his sixth 20-plus point effort this year. Cowboys looking for more. Asbury trailing. Whistle and a foul on the floor. It's on John Michael Wright of Oklahoma State.
Boy, Thompson has hit enough of these. I mean, look at the space right there. You have to be, in the very least, underneath Thompson on the catch. Allegri certainly can appreciate that because Oklahoma State has allowed him too much space at times. You see, Thompson has 22 points on those six made threes. And again, most of the time, the ball has found him. He does have some mid-range, James Thompson, and can get going there. But I think he's best away from the ball. Let the ball find him, ball movement. Let him get his feet set and knock him down.
His 10th performance this season with three or more threes. Oklahoma State has a comfortable lead with under four to go. Shot clock in the single digits, drive and kick. Another offensive foul called on Bryce Thompson. Oklahoma State, they lead by 12.
We'll be right back.
Sanity at Slim Chickens, featuring a head-to-head matchup of two new wing flavors. Get some saucy sweet heat, honey hot, a glaze of honey mixed with maple and smoldering cayenne, or that tangy southern taste of Carolina Gold, a zesty rich southern sauce with a subtle kick. Try them with a meal or feed your hungry crowd. Delicious additions to the House Wing Flavors lineup. Take your Slim Sanity to the next level and play the game for a chance to win. Only at Slim Chickens.
For 46 years straight, more of you have trusted Ford F-Series trucks to help save the day. Stretch the weekend. Haul or tow. Just about anything, anywhere. That's because they're built Ford tough. And it's why Ford F-Series are America's best-selling trucks 46 years straight. And for that, we thank you. Because this isn't just about our capability. It's about yours.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. Next stop, Final Four.
Action coming up on ESPN, North Texas and Sam Houston on ESPN Plus at 4 Eastern, then UCF Oregon followed by Utah Valley and Colorado. UAB leads Morehead State at the half, 39-27, but watch out for these non-Power 6 teams. Just in the last four NITs, here's a list of non-Power 6 schools that have made the semifinals. St. Bonaventure, Memphis, Colorado State, Louisiana Tech, Lipscomb, Wichita State, Western Kentucky. Strong bunch.
I would expect that would, or that trend would continue this year. And I know I mentioned the first half. That Sam Houston North Texas matchup here at 3 o'clock. That's on ESPN Plus.
Stroud bumping, couldn't hit it. You have a favorite non-power six school to make a deep run?
Classify Cincinnati.
AAC there. Would be considered non-power six, but I do get what you're saying in terms of that league being
that's
stout.
Who I like. Put me on the spot there. I strike.
Williams feathers it in.
I tell you what, he's gotten better with his decision making, but Mike Boynton really credited Smith and Williams' energy up in Youngstown as really being the catalyst, especially the second half. Now Williams will take a marginal shot or two or three. But if you have a high motor and you're willing to defend and rebound, you know, that's where his minutes have been earned and his trust as of late with Coach Boynton, along with Smith. You can coach that, right? When you know what you're going to get out of a guy. It's easier to make decisions on those sidelines.
Williams, the freshman, has played 23 minutes today. Foul on the other end was on Jones, his second for Eastern Washington after a missed three. There's the Frosh with the ball. Posing, gives it up, throws it away.
Yeah, wrong side right there. You got to read the defender behind that post play.
Davis hanging, and he hits.
Obviously, if you're Oklahoma State, I mean, at this point, it's take care of it. Assuming you do that, you're going to have to hit free throws to seal this one.
Right. Blocked. Out of bounds. Into the crowd. There's went airborne. Oklahoma State by 12, less than two to go.
You can feel confident Continental is the smart choice in tires.
Can they handle extremes?
Yep. Tested from the Texas desert to near the Arctic Circle.
Really?
Really.
Anything for the guy who finds that one pothole?
Yeah. Road hazard coverage has your back.
For real?
Absolutely.
Were they made by, like, a bajillion engineers?
Well, closer to 100. Continental. Welcome to the smart choice in tires.
Alongside former Oklahoma State guard Brendan Manzer, I'm James Wesley. Here's a different region. This is Cincinnati, Vanderbilt in the quarterfinals. Utah Valley, Colorado. That'll be a fantastic game. Utah Valley went to the pit, went to Albuquerque.
Yeah, you were there.
Stomped New Mexico earlier
this week.
You
really, really like. I mean, you know, I always, you know, you're watching on TV, but I always feel better when I see teams in person. Have a better feel, but you were there. And what'd you like about them?
Their connectivity. The way they shoot, they have a big in the middle, and Bandego's third in the nation in blocks. He's a seven-footer, and they're outstanding in terms of the head of their bench. Mark Madsen's done a phenomenal job. Coach of the year in their league. Oklahoma State, this could be showtime. Allegri. Cross court skip to Venters. Still can't buy one. Offensive rebound, the stick back from Coward. Ten-point lead for Oklahoma State with a minute 19 left. Timeout on the floor. Bryce Thompson, his sixth 20-plus point game for Oklahoma State this season. He's got 22.
Threes early, in rhythm. That one there was a heat check because he'd made one the previous possession. Little jab step, create space. I mean, his threes have come really in a lot of different ways. Movement away from the ball. And he has been here today. And it really started for him, having those opportunities, Oklahoma State's initiative and commitment to get the ball inside. And I can't tell you how many games I've done over the years where coaches say, you know, we want to establish the interior. They throw it in a couple times early. Something good happens. Never to throw it in there again. But Oklahoma State stuck to the plan, which led, I believe, to freeing up the three-point shot, in particular for Bryce Thompson.
Oklahoma State as a unit, 11 of 24 today from downtown. Obviously, Thompson a huge part of that with six. But John Michael Wright also has three. And then Asbury and Williams connected on triples. Washington will foul, down by 10 with a minute 14 left. The threes haven't been dropping, you saw there for Eastern Washington, 8 of 28 today. Oklahoma State, 13th NIT appearance, their first ever one seed. They will match their deepest NIT run in program history. They made the quarterfinals back in 2017. Be win number 20 for the Cowboys if they hang on. What do you like about Williams, the freshman? How good could he be?
Athletic. You know, even though he's young, I mean, look at his frame right there. You know, over the summers, even next year, he can develop that. He has a high motor. He loves to play. Got to work on that decision-making, though. But it has been better here the last couple weeks. You know, the more minutes he's gotten. You know, you lose Chris Harris, key senior off the bench, who played meaningful minutes, has another knee injury. So Williams has got to play. He's really that eighth person in their eight-player rotation.
He's going back to the stripe. 7 points today, four assists, a couple of rebounds. From Jonesboro, Arkansas, he was Class 5A All-State a season ago. To eight now for the Cowboys. Oklahoma State by 14.
You know, Oklahoma State was able to just kind of keep them at arm's length, right? And the one thing that Eastern Washington doesn't have they are is a downhill closer. And so when you're trying to get back in it, you have to get downhill, whether that frees up a three-point shot or you're able to get to the rim. You know, also with that, you have Cisse and Smith in there for Oklahoma State waiting on you. And so it was a tough matchup in terms of that with Eastern Washington getting down in this ball game here this afternoon.
Corner three, in and out. Oklahoma State top 20 in the nation in blocks per game. They were bothering shots at the rim all day. A nice win for the Cowboys.
Well, James, credit Oklahoma State. Disappointed you don't get in the tournament. Literally the last one out. And they could have hung their head. They had to go on the road because of conflicts in the Oklahoma State Athletic Department. But they didn't want to go out like that. Great win in Youngstown. Great second half. And they played very well today. I mean, this was a team that very much was interested in being here. And then David Riley, great season. Great continued days ahead for he and that program.
Eastern Washington will end their season 23-11. But they'd won a program record 18 games in a row prior to a three-game losing streak that started February 25th. They also won their first 16 Big Sky Conference games, becoming the first team in league history to start 16-0. 11-point win for Oklahoma State. Mike Boynton has another 20-win season at the helm of this program. An updated NIT bracket. Oklahoma State awaits the winner of North Texas and Sam Houston. That game tipping off just moments away over on ESPN Plus. 71-60 our final for Brendan Manzer.